probably know, you and I know most about his team through one Tyler Shipp. We also want to welcome to the booth with us, Mark Weinberg. Welcome.
Thank you, guys.
So happy to have you here, Mr. Weinberg. You're like a celebrity here. You're at all of the HRA MMA fights.
Are you at all of them?
I am honestly almost at every single one. I've been an MMA fan, all combat sports fan, honestly, for years. So you guys have seen me out here. I mean, I travel pretty much anywhere HR MMA is.
Yeah, we certainly appreciate that from you. I think it's long overdue that we have you guest commentate a fight with us, and we're very appreciative of it.
I appreciate it. Anytime you guys want me, man, I'm always here to come over and enjoy myself.
Thank you.
Now, does this mean I have to take you guys storm chasing with me?
Oh, but any day, I would love to.
I'd certainly be open to that.
Yeah, Mr. Weinberg, have you seen Tyler Shipp? Are you familiar with him?
I have not seen him fight, no.
Okay, so Tyler Shipp, of course, is the number one guy that most people know out of Team Demon. He was the HR MMA heavyweight champion, light heavyweight champion, and middleweight champion all at once. He hasn't fought in a little bit. I think he just wanted to take some time off from fighting.
He's like 6-0 as an amateur.
Yeah, he was 6-0 as an amateur.
The champ.
All finishes.
Next big thing for the state of Kentucky.
Yep.
And Tyler Mangiacaro gets to train with him a lot.
Yeah, that's his number one training partner. And then here coming out, we have Trevor Goldsmith, Louisville Combat Academy. Kelly, what do we know about Trevor?
We know Trevor is making his debut. You know, I've got a little bit of information about him. He wanted me to make sure that I let everybody know he really loves it at Louisville Combat Academy, located at 10105 Dixie Highway, Louisville, Kentucky, 40272. He gets to train with the Fergusons, with Lingo, with Jacob Pierce, with Brandon Bishop. He gets to train with the who's who of the local MMA scene at Louisville Combat Academy.
Kelly, is it true? I heard a rumor that Louisville Combat Academy might be sponsoring you. Is that true?
That is 100% true.
Okay.
Yes. Trevor wanted me to give a shout out to his favorite musician, Wheeler Walker Jr.
We'd like to welcome back those of you watching at home.
Mr. Weinberg, are you familiar with Louisville Combat Academy at all?
Yeah, Ferguson's.
Yeah.
Isaiah's on the card a little bit later on fight number 9 tonight.
Yeah, I think that's a fight that deserved to be the main event.
I know, I'm surprised.
I believe what happened was they didn't want it to be the main event. The last time, we'll remember.
Everybody leaves.
The last time, yeah, everyone would leave out of here. The last time that Isaiah fought, he was the main event, Hard Rock 100.
Downtown Louisville.
Yeah, that was
you were there.
That was his first fight in several years. He fought against one Ken Beverly, who's gone on to fight LFA and is pushing the UFC envelope. I think that they think that Isaiah kind of wasn't ready for that moment, which is why they wanted to just be the first professional fight tonight.
That was an evenly matched fight, too, because it was Ken Beverly was just slightly better in a lot of places that Isaiah Ferguson was good at, and it felt like he was just a little better in all places.
Yeah, Ken was just able to slip out of every little submission.
So back to Trevor Goldsmith. He said in this camp he got to work a lot with Graham Gordon.
Good jab.
Ooh, good
there.
Shot.
Yeah, Trevor's sticking that jab out there. Tyler's just coming right underneath. I think Tyler's stuck in a right hand there on the cage. Goldsmith just backs right off. He's bouncing around. So tall. His chin's kind of up in the air. He might eat one here soon if he doesn't get that chin down. You see Mangiacaro
way up in the air.
Yeah, Mangiacaro's doing a good job. Hands up, moving his head side to side. Looks like Mangiacaro's got some good striking technique. He snuck in that right hand again.
Trevor Goldsmith did a good job of hugging him. He said, I got, he caught him. I'm going to hug you, minimize the damage you can do to me.
He's definitely wanting to strike. He keeps backing away. He's trying to set his distance.
Yeah, Goldsmith is the much longer fighter for sure.
Just got to be careful with that chin up.
Good head movement there. He dodged one.
Yeah, chin was all up in the air. And the more immediate problem that we see is that Goldsmith is backing up, and he's just running straight back, and he keeps ending up with his back on the cage, as we see here. Not good. If you want to kill your own range, that's how you do it. Goldsmith is the much taller and longer fighter. He needs to have this fight in the center of the cage.
Yeah, he does not want to be locked up in the clinch.
Goldsmith is trying to use some pitter-patter type punches from a distance.
I mean, he's just walking right into the shots, but once he gets his distance.
About a minute left in this first round.
Yeah, he's weathering the storm here. He's doing a good job of putting Mangiacaro on the cage.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Oh, he's hurt.
Yeah, this fight's over.
That's it.
Yeah.
Boy, the ref is letting him take a lot of punches tonight.
Yeah, we were.
I don't even think he knows where he is right now.
No, that's sad. You hate to see that. He'll be okay.
Mangiacaro, his striking coach is Andrew Wood. Jiu-jitsu coach is Davey Gerhart.
Just a couple of things he needs to tighten up. He's got that range. He needs to use that a little bit more. And he did not. Once the other guy, Goldsmith closed the distance, it was a problem.
And Goldsmith has some really good jiu-jitsu that we didn't even get to see.
Yeah, that's unfortunate, you know. But sometimes that's the way it goes. This is the game. I hope we see Goldsmith back in here fighting again soon.
Ladies and gentlemen, the referee was called to sound in this fight at 2 minutes with 34 seconds, declaring the winner by TKO Tyler LT Mangiacaro.
He said his main training partners are Tyler Shipp and Max Newman. Said he did kickboxing for 2 years when he was 18. Then he took a hiatus and came back to do MMA.
It shows.
We saw that kickboxing on display there.
Absolutely.
And see